press these molds with clay. I've had these molds for 2 years in plaster-hydrocal. They're a sculpture of a hand. They're all in parts. Once you press the mold in a day or two, the mold will dry and pop out, and then I'll begin to put it together and break it apart again to fire it in pieces, and then bring it back together once they're fired. And I'll put them back together with resin, a special type of resin, bonded glue or a grout, and then paint it with oils or polyurethane, graphite, oil, enamels. Try to get at least an inch deep so that I can scrape off half an inch. And as long as they're half an inch thick, that should be enough to hold the shape. Depending on the shape, because this is a very large shape, you want it to be half an inch for warping and shrinkage. When you dry the molds, when you dry these pieces, as they dry, they'll shrink about 5%. Try to take out as much air from the clay as you can, although the coarser the clay, the more grog, which is an additive, which is inert, will let it breathe, but it'll be stronger, and it can take more expansion if there is a bubble when you're firing it. If there's too big a bubble and the clay is too fine, it'll explode in the kiln and it'll ruin the piece. pressing a mold inside of a plaster is that there's a, you cannot have plaster in the ceramic because it'll explode in the kiln. So you have to be careful that whatever plaster there is, you pull it out as you press the mold in. It has to be, you use the plaster, but you have to pick it all apart, like almost dust pieces out of the clay before firing, otherwise it'll explode and break in the mold in the oven.